For a fourth consecutive day, an earthquake shook eastern Connecticut this morning. We're all wondering at this point, why is this happening? When will it likely stop? News 8's Tina Dattel took those questions and others to an expert at Eastern Connecticut State University.
Nearly a dozen earthquakes in 1 week, and as that number continues to grow, so do concerns here in Plainfield. We went to Eastern Connecticut State University to try to get some answers.
You see this bold red line, which turns the corner here and then goes north, okay? And this is where the earthquakes have occurred along this.
Geology professor Dickinson Cunningham says Plainfield runs along the Lake Char Fault, which dates back 300 million years. He says the yellow dots on this map show the small quakes, like we've seen, are common in New England. They're also shallow, going only a few miles down.
I don't think anyone should be too alarmed at this stage. The probabilities are low that something more significant will happen, but they're not impossible.
Major damage comes with earthquakes of a 5 magnitude strength or stronger.
And we heard, you know, loud glass break, and we flew downstairs and we had glasses on the ground and bottles.
A light fixture also fell from the ceiling. While the damage so far has been minor, the quakes have still shaken up residents.
You know, we just want to know really what's going on, maybe when this will kind of end. I mean, we kind of have like a permanent alarm clock now, but a scary one.
I'm very concerned. I actually was thinking about moving to Rhode Island again because that's where I originally came from.
Along with checking their homes, health officials say folks should also be checking their water for any odd odor or taste, especially if they have a private well. Now, information on that and much more will be discussed at the high school on Friday night during an informational meeting about earthquakes. That will be at 6:30. In Plainfield, Tina Dattel, News 8.